So how many of you would say that you get most of your information about the world from watching or from reading the newspaper or from maybe watching the nightly news with your parents? What about places like Snapchat, Facebook, BuzzFeed? Raise your hands if you would say you get most of your news from one of those three places. Because, well, I know I do. And I'm sure it wouldn't surprise you to know that according to a study done by the Business Insider Australia, 64% of individuals aged 18 to 24 get most of their information about the world, their news, from online sources. And so the internet is clearly a very impactful part of our lives, especially for our generation. It's the place where we watch movies, talk to people, get our memes, and find our news. So, I bet you're asking right about now how exactly this relates to my topic, the idea of news as the newest reality TV show. Well, reality TV are programs which are filming individuals in real life situations, showing their real reactions. They're shows such as The Kardashians, Keeping Up with the Kardashians, Big Brother, The Bachelor. I'm sure I could name many more. However, with the popularization of the internet as a source for news, news production has started to become more parallel to this model of providing an entertainment source rather than a place to show the facts. So as I said, one of the key players in this reality TV news for me has been the internet. And the internet has probably been one of the best and the worst things for the news these days. Because on one hand, the internet has allowed this news to reach masses of people very quickly, so people are able to know what's going on all around the world rather than just in their own backyard. However, the double-edged sword with this is that we expect news at the click of a button. So that means journalists are having to write these articles either while or after a story has just broken. And I don't know if you guys have ever tried to submit work or write at last minute, but it's never your best work. It's full of mistakes. And so these journalists are expected to write these articles in 5 to 10 minutes. And they publish them and sometimes have to republish them 5 or 6 times to even get the facts straight. Another issue is that it's a lot harder to tell how reputable exactly a source is. So say I might be scrolling the internet and find an article by The Onion, which is a satirical site which shows jokes. However, others may come across this exact same article but expect it to be real because that's what they think this source of news is. And so, another thing, if I was to ask probably most people the biggest impact the internet has had on the news, for many people, that would be the fact of the popularization of this phenomenon called fake news. So, fake news is false, often sensationalized information produced under the guise of legitimate news sources. So it's things such as following the Las Vegas shooting, there were tweets and articles published about the assailant or the shooter. And so like this tweet, for example, the picture shown above is actually not the assailant, but rather an American comedian called Sam Hyde, who had nothing to do with the event. But people still publish these photos of him as the shooter. There were even posts about fake claims for victims of the event. So, a study was conducted by the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, which found that on Twitter, falsehoods are spread 6 times as fast to 1,500 people. So, I would estimate that in MLC, there would probably be around 1,500 people from years 5 to 12. So that would be the same as me, for example, telling one of my friends that, oh, next year we're going to be able to wear our hair down every day and have as many piercings as we want. And so that news may take 1 day to spread around the entire school. However, the same news but with the truth that, well, no, that's actually not going to happen, takes 6 days to spread to that exact same population of people. That same institute did a study that found that news articles which are false are 70% times more likely to be shared than true news. And why, you ask? Fake news is more novel, and people are more likely to share more novel information. What's the point in sharing some news story everyone knows? People share these things because they're interesting and engaging. So, Jason DeMyers found that 59% of people never actually click on an article before they share it on places like Twitter or Facebook. So that's people merely looking at just the title and the picture and deciding to share it. But I don't know about you guys, the amount of times I've gone to click on an article just because the headline sounded amazing and then started reading it and it had nothing to do with the topic or was just plain nonsensical. So the issue with this is that people are more likely to remember these short novel headlines to these catchy articles than they are to actually remember the content. So I remember one time I was scrolling through Facebook and I came along across this article talking about two Palestinian men who were killed. It wasn't until I actually clicked on the article where I found out that these men were not the victims, but actually the assailants of a crime who were killed by police on the scene. So, yeah. And after this, the Columbia Journalism Review in America looked at one magazine that paid writers $100 a month, and on top of that, $5 per every 500 clicks on their article. And that seems like quite a good incentive for journalists to write these clickbait articles, or more fluff pieces, things that they expect to get clicks, like the top 10 dog breeds to own. And so this leads me on to my next idea of the use of sensationalism in the media. So sensationalism is a type of media, it's a type of editorial bias found in the mass media, where stories are overhyped or changed to put a spin or a bias on the topic. So I'm sure many of you remember the Barnaby Joyce saga. So I remember reading these articles and thinking the issue with this was the fact that he had an affair with one of his staffers. But it wasn't actually until later that I realised it was because of the ethical and moral implications of him promoting a staffer in his office, promoting his staffer who he also had this interest or affair with. The other issue with this idea of sensationalism is that it talks about this human factor, but also very much normalizes the sledging and attacks of people. So I remember recently someone close to me was in quite a big media news scandal. I don't think the specificities for this are very important, but essentially front page news, first story on the nightly news for quite a while. And so because of this, everyone who thought they could possibly have an opinion on the subject seemed to post these journalistic pieces, which were more opinion pieces under the guise of true journalism. So these pieces were less about the facts of the incident and more attacking the character of a man they had never met because of one single incident they had heard he was a part of. And so I remember I was at a GAV after this, or the adult equivalent of the GAV, I'm not sure that is these days. And this man and his family happened to be there. And so one of his kids was stuck by his side the entire time. And it wasn't until after that I talked to someone and I actually found out the reason this child, this The reason this 9 or 10 year old child was stuck by his leg or by his side the entire time was not any sort of normal shyness. It was the fact that she was terrified to talk to anyone at that event because she was worried that they would say something bad about her father. And that's because this sledging and attacks of character had become normalized to her, because so many people had been doing it, that's what she kind of learned to expect from people. So, now moving on to the question, is sensationalism and this dramatization and reality TV news a bad thing? Well, trust me, I'll be the first one to say that it's not always a bad thing. Sometimes trying to get through some articles that I know are really important are hard because they're so dull. Nothing interesting about them, but they're very important to actually get around to people. So this sensationalism or entertainment value is very important because articles that need to reach people need to have a certain sort of draw so people are actually going to read them. The issue is when news shifts, it's when this news goes out to the world. This fake news goes out to the world under the guise of legitimate news. And so now, what can we do? Well, I know everyone always tells us that we're the future. So shouldn't it be our job to right now maybe look a little bit more carefully before we read an article or share something to figure out whether or not it's true? And then to, as we move forward in the world, try and move towards a journalism that focuses more on this reality than this reality TV. Ooh, thank you.